हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर मैथमेटिकल लॉजिक ऑफ 12th साइंस, एक्सरसाइज 1.2, क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. सो सी द क्वेश्चन, दैट इज यूजिंग ट्रूथ टेबल प्रूव द लॉजिकल इक्विवेलेंस. नाउ सी, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ लॉजिकल इक्विवेलेंस? सो यू आर गिवन द टू स्टेटमेंट्स हियर. द इन बिटवीन दिस टू स्टेटमेंट पैटर्न देर इज एन इक्वालिटी साइन. सो दिस पार्ट वी कंसिडर एज अ S1, दैट इज लेफ्ट पार्ट, and the right part we consider as a S2. So we have to prove that this S1 is equals to S2, means the column of S1, that is this column and the column of S2 are equal. So see how we can prove this one. So since there are two simple statements, that is P and Q, so first we start with the P and Q. So negation P, so we start with this negation P. Then I write this S1, that is negation P conjunction Q. After that, we have to write down this P disjunction Q. Then we already write this negation P, so there is no need to write it again. Just we have to write down this S2 part, that is P disjunction Q conjunction negation P. And I give here the number for the column, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what is our aim? Aim is we have to prove that this part. So find out where is this, that is in the fourth column it is, that is negation P conjunction Q. So this S1 is in the fourth column and this S2 part in the sixth column. So we have to show that the fourth column and sixth columns are same, and that is nothing but the logical equivalence. So we start with this, that is TTFF, TFTF. So negation of P, so for this true we will write false, and for this false we write true. Now we have to find out the conjunction between negation of P and Q. So first we have to see this column, and after that we have to see this one. So what is the rule for the conjunction? If both the statements are true, then it is true, otherwise it is false. Now see, true, true, so it is true, and then write down the remaining. Next one, that is fifth one, we have to find out, that is P disjunction Q. So rule for the disjunction is, if both the statements are false, then it is false. So see here, if both those statements are false, then it is false, otherwise it is true. So I write here true. And now last one, that is P disjunction Q conjunction negation P. So find out this one, that is P disjunction Q is here and negation P is here. So we have to take the conjunction between fifth column and the third column. First we have to see the fifth column, and then we have to see the third column. So conjunction for rule for the conjunction, then if the both the statements are true, then it is true, otherwise it is false. So here we can see that in both the columns there are true, so here we write true and the remainings are false. Now we have to find out the negation P conjunction Q is in the fourth column. We already find out this one, and fourth one and sixth one we have to check whether they are same. So FF TT and FF. So we have to write down like this one. The entries in the columns 4 and 6 are identical, and so S1 is equals to S2. So all examples we have to solve like this way. Now I am going to solve the second example, that is negation of P disjunction Q conjunction negation of P conjunction Q is equals to negation of P. Now again there are two simple statements, so we have to write down P and Q. So TTFF, that is TFTF. In this example there is a negation P, so I write here negation P. Next one, that is P disjunction Q. After that negation P, I write here, that is negation of P disjunction Q. After that this one, that is negation P conjunction Q, and at last the conjunction of this whole part, that is negation of P disjunction Q disjunction negation P conjunction Q. This total S1 part is here. Now find out where is S1 and where is S2. So S1 is in the last column, that is 7th column, and S2 is in the negation P, that is 3rd column. So we have to show that is 3rd and 7th column are same. So as usual, TTFF, TFTF, negation P, you know how to write down. If there is a true, then you have to write down false, true, false. And for this both of F, you have to write down T. Next, that is P disjunction Q. Now see, you know the rule for the disjunction. If both the statements are false, then it is false and the remainings are true. Now for this bracket, we have to write down the negation. So for this column, every values will become negative. That is, true becomes false, 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 and this false becomes true, since there is a negation sign. Now we have to write down the negation of P and Q. There is a conjunction. So see, negation of P and Q. We have to find out the conjunction between these two columns. So first we have to see the third column and then we see the second column. So since there is a conjunction, first we have to find out if there are both the statements are true, then it is true. See here, both the statements are true, then it is true, and the remaining values are false. And the last one, that is negation of P disjunction Q, means which column? That is fifth column. And negation P conjunction Q. So we have to write down the disjunction between these two columns. So first we have to see the fifth column, then sixth column. So since there is a disjunction, if both the values are F, then it is F, otherwise it is true. So both are F, so F, and the remainings are true. Now we have to compare this S1, that is seventh statement, with the negation P, that is third. So we have to compare this third and seventh column. See, both the values are same, FFTT, here is also FFTT. And so we have to write down the entries in the columns 3 and 7 are identical, and so S1 is equals to S2. Next, the third example, that is P biconditional Q. So this is S1, this part is S1, and the RHS, that is negation of in bracket P disjunction Q conjunction negation of P conjunction Q, and this total part is of S2. So since there are two simple statements, so PQ, then I write here, that is P biconditional Q. So this is S1 our. Next one, first we find out P disjunction Q, after that we will find P conjunction Q, after that we will find the negation of this P conjunction Q, and then we will find the conjunction between these two conjunction, and after that we have to take the negation of this seventh column. So that is the S2. So since there is no proper space, I write here, that is S2. In this total part, that is the negation of this total part, we have to write down here. So this is our eighth column. So what is our aim? That is, we have to prove that is third column and the last column, that is eighth column, are same. Now see, again, that is TTFF, TFTF. So you know the rule for the biconditional, if both the statements are true, same, that is true or false, then it is true, otherwise it is false. Disjunction, if both the statements are false, then it is false, otherwise it is true. Conjunction, if both the statements are true, then it is true, otherwise it is false. Next, we have to write down the negation of P conjunction Q. So the negation means we have to write down the opposite values, T, then F, it is F, F, then it is T, T, and it is T. Now we have to take the conjunction between these two statements, that is P disjunction Q and the negation, that is conjunction between 4 and 6, fourth column and sixth column. So we have to take the conjunction. So see the rule for the conjunction, if both the statements are true, then it is true, otherwise it is false. And the last column is our S2, means we have to write down the negation of the seventh column. So what is the negation of the seventh column? So F, then it is true. True, then it is F, F, and if it is F, then it is true. Now we have to compare S1. S1 is our in the third column. Means we have to compare third and eighth. See, are they similar? Yes. So T, T, both are F, and last one is T, T. And so since the entries in the column third and eighth are identical, so S1 is equals to S2. Next, the example number 4, that is P conditional Q conditional P is equals to negation of P conditional P conditional Q. Since again there are two statements, so PQ we write here, then we can write that is Q conditional P. After that we write this S1, that is P conditional in bracket Q conditional P. Then we write here that is a negation P, then P conditional Q, and this total S2, that is negation P conditional in bracket P conditional Q. Now again TTFF TFTF Q conditional P. So Q conditional P. So first we have to see the second column first and then first column. So Q conditional P means what? The condition for the conditional, that is first statement must be true and second one is false, then it is false, otherwise it is true. So see here in the third row we see the first statement is true and second one is false, so it is false and so the remaining are true. Next we have to write down the P conditional with this third column, means first column, and in between first and third we have to show the conditional. So see this first one and then it is second, same, that is conditional, first statement must be true and second one must be false, then it is false. Yes, is there any condition we can see? No. So all the statements are true here. So this is my S1. Remember, this one is fourth one is our S1. Now negation P. So you know how to write down the negation P, opposite values of this one. So we write here next P conditional Q. So see now P and Q, so we have to write down the conditional in between this. So first statement is true, second one is false, so it is false and the remaining are true. And the last we have to write down the conditional between these two, again the same, that is first statement must be true and second one must be false, then it is false. Yes, are there any members? No. So all the statements are true. Now we have to compare this S1. So S1 is in the fourth column and S2 is in the seventh column. So 4 and 7 are same exactly. And so we have to write down the entries in the columns 4 and 7 are same. So S1 is equals to S2. Now the example number 5. So all examples are same. Just we have to use the truth table properly and then you will get the answer. Method are same. Now see P disjunction Q. Now there is third statement, that is R. Conditional R is equals to P conditional R conjunction Q conditional R. So this one is S1 and this one is the S2. Now see, we have to write down the P, Q, R first. So you know how to write down if there are three simple statements. So 4 times T, 4 times F, then TTFF, TTFF, TFTF, TFTF. So these three columns completed. Then P disjunction Q. So in between P and Q, we are trying to write down the disjunction. So rule for the disjunction, if both the statements are false, then it is false, otherwise it is true. So find out if both are false. Yes, so both are false, both are false. So here we write false, otherwise the remainings are true. Next one, then we have to write down the P disjunction Q conditional with R. So see, P disjunction Q is in the fourth column and R is in the third column. So we have to find out the conditional between 4 to 3. 4, hame 4 se 3 mein dekhna hai. So conditional, the rules for the conditional, that is first statement must be true and second false, then it is false. So see, we get here also we get, that is first one is true, then it is and second one is false, then it is false. Yes, again there is, that is first statement is true, second one is false, so it is false and the remaining are true. Now P conditional R. So we have to find out the conditional between first and third one. Again the same, that is if first statement is true, second one is false. So see here again, that is P conditional R. Yes, we see the P conditional R again. So P and R. So first statement is true and the second one is false, then it is false, otherwise it is true. So here it is true. First statement is true and the second one is false, so it is false. Find out the remaining statement. Here also, first statement is true and second one is false, so it is false. No other statements are like this one. So the remaining are the true statements. Now Q conditional R. So see, q and r. So there is a condition between q and r. So find out the first statement is true, then second false, then it is false. So see here false. Again, first statement is true, second one is false, so it is false, and the remaining are the true statements. And the last one, that is, we have to find out the conjunction between 6 and 7. Since p conditional r and q conditional r, there is a conjunction between these two. So the rule for the conjunction is, if both the statements are true, then it is true, otherwise it is false. So it is true, here also it is true, here also it is true, and here is also true, and the remainings are false. Now we have to compare between S1 and S2. So S1 is in the which column, just find out. So it is in the fifth column. Yes, and the S2 is in the eighth column. So we have to compare the column 5th and 8th. So compare it. You will see that is the columns are exactly same. And so we can write here the entries in the columns 5th and 8th are same. So S1 is equals to S2. So remaining examples we have to solve like this one. So we are going to continue the question number 3rd. So examine whether each of the following statement pattern is tautology, contradiction or contingence. It is also very easy concept. In the first question we solve this statement pattern, just like we have to solve this one. Again see, that is there is no logical equivalence, no equality sign, just we have to write down the statement patterns, that is truth table for the statement pattern. So since there are two simple statements, so P and Q are there. So I'm just writing P conjunction Q, again Q disjunction P, and in between these two there is a condition. So it is the last one. So since two statements are there, TTFF, TFTF. So conjunction, if both the statements are true, then it is true, otherwise it is false. Disjunction, in between Q and P. So if both the statements are false, then it is false, otherwise it is true. And now we have to see the conditional between these two. So if the statement, first statement is true and second one is false, then it is false, otherwise it is true. So no any condition we see like this one, that is first statement is true and second one is false. So all the statements are true. Now see, in the last column we see that is all the answers are true. If we get like this one, means all the answers are true in the last column of the statement pattern, then it is called as the tautology. If all the answers in the last column of the statement pattern are true, then it is called as a true, or it is also say that is T, then it is called as a tautology. Similarly, if all the answers are false, that is F, in the last column of the statement pattern, then it is called as a contradiction. And if there is no tautology, no contradiction, then it is called as a contingence. I repeat it again. If the last column of the statement pattern is true, that is T, then it is called as a tautology. If the last column of the statement pattern is all F, that is false, then it is contradiction. And if there is no tautology, no contradiction, then that is mixing of true and false, then it is called as a contingence. Just I solve here the one examples of tautology, contradiction and contingency. And we have to write down like this one, that is all entries in the last column of this statement pattern are true, that is T. So the given statement pattern is tautology. Next I am going to solve the example number 8, that is P conjunction negation Q, biconditional P conditional Q. So see, there are two statements, so P, Q, we write here, then we have to write down the negation Q, since there is a negation Q, then P conjunction negation Q, then we write that is P conditional Q, and last there is a biconditional between these two brackets. So write this one. So TTFF, TFTF, negation Q, so TF, FT, TF and FT. Now we have to write down the conjunction between these two, first and the third column. So rule for the conjunction, so you know that is if both the statements are true, then it is true, otherwise it is false. Next, the conditional between P and Q. If first statement is true, second one is false, then it is false, otherwise it is true. And the last one, that is P conjunction negation Q, that is this column and this column. In between this column, in these two columns, we have to find out the biconditional. So biconditional rules, that is both the statements are same, that is FF or TT, then it is true, otherwise it is false. So no statements are common, that is same, no FF, no TT, so all these statements are false, and hence it is called as a contradiction. So all entries in the last column are F, that is false, and so this given statement pattern is called as a contradiction. See, you can compare all the entries are true, so it is tautology. All the entries are false, so it is contradiction. Now we are going to take one example of contingency also. So see the example number 9. So negation P, conditional Q, conjunction P, conjunction R. So there are three statements. So we write here P, Q, R. So you know 4 times T, 4 times F, T, T, F, F, T, T, F, F, T, F, T, F, T, F, T, F. Now we have tried on first negation P. So we have tried on the opposite values of P. So you know how to write down it. Next one, negation P and conditional Q. So see, negation P and Q. So in between these two, means if I give the numbers, that is 1, here is 2, 3 and 4. So see here, we have to take the conditional between 4 and 2. First we have to see the fourth column and then we have to see the second column. So negation P, conditional Q. So you know the rules for the conditional. First statement must be true. So find out the first statement true. Yes, here is first statement is true. And we want the second one is false. Is there any false? No. So all the entries are true. Here we get that is TF, TF. So it is false. Now we have to write down the P, conjunction R. So 1 and 3rd, in between 1 and 3rd we have to find out conjunction. So the rule for the conjunction, both the statements are true, then it is true, otherwise it is false. So here is true, again here is true, and the remainings, there are no true statements both, so all the entries are false. And now we have to find out the conjunction between these two statements. So this column, that is 5th column and 6th column, we have to take the conjunction. So conjunction means if both are true, then it is true, it is false, again it is true, false, 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 false and false. So see, two entries are true and the remainings are false. So it's neither tautology not a contradiction, so it is called as a contingency. So the entries in the last column are neither T or nor F, so it is called as a contingency. So remaining examples we have to solve like this way. So this is all about the exercise 1.2 of the chapter logic. So remaining examples we will solve in the next lecture. Thank you.